Okay, intentions today for prayer. Rachel?
A special intention for the man that had the tumor open my church. He's doing really well. He's back at home.
Good. Yes.
For the family of that little boy in Frankfurt who got shot in the neck.
I didn't hear about it, but yeah, definitely. India? Okay. Anyone else? Justine? Okay. Hannah? Okay. Ashley? Okay. John? Man, it's pretty sick. It's 60 out there right now. Keep it going. Keep it going. Yeah, how about my homily? And then it's like 70 when we walk out of church. I'm like, there you go. Yeah. The less fortunate? Yep, definitely. Okay. Anyone else? Certainly pray for Casey and his family. Continue to do that. Casey Mormon. Anyone want to take prayer today? In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Lord, we ask you to continue to look down on us. Those of us who are suffering or despairing in any way, please bring us light, that we the light of your presence, if that be your will. We pray for all of those who are hurting or who are suffering or in pain. Pray that we may reach out to those around us and love those who we find in our midst each day. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You can get out your packets that we had from last class. If you would do that, please.
I go to my watch.
Nope. Basso, what's Basso do?
YouTube all day.
What's that?
YouTube all day.
In class? Like you would watch them, or he would just do them on the side? As part of class? Were they good, or?
Dora the Explorer.
It's called
Conceived the Door.
Okay.
Check it out after.
I'm lost, but that's par for the course. I'm usually lost. Conquistadora the Explorer. Okay. Gotcha. I'm sure it did. Okay, the thing that I had you read last night for class. Shh. All right, two nights ago or last night whenever you did the homework, probably last night, we read the excerpt from I Am Charlotte Simmons, a very famous book recently written by Tom Wolfe. Okay, and it was about... you know what it was about because you read it, hopefully, right? And I just took just one excerpt from the book, okay? From the chapter, obviously. You could just dive in there and kind of get the gist of what's going on. Why do you think that I had you read that? What was the point of that little excerpt? Anybody got any guesses? Kari? Yeah.
And how she was participating in pleasure.
Yeah.
But she was really doing it so she could get attention.
Some underage, she was really doing it for attention. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
I said it related to like discernment.
Okay.
She didn't, like at first, she didn't want to like do the stuff like that she ended up doing.
Yeah.
Like she was hearing God's call to like be involved in six or four roles, but she just didn't know how to use it.
Right.
Because she was like around all those people.
Yeah. Yeah. Good. What else? Guess what happens to her?
Date rape.
Date rape. Date rape. Yeah. She gets date raped. And the rest of the story is about how she deals with that. How she goes through a severe depression, how some friends help her out of that, how ultimately the guy gets his due, if you will. Very well written, very very famous story. Alana, what were you saying? I'm sorry. You wrote that? That you thought that was going to happen? Yeah. Yeah. But the reason I had you guys read that is because we were talking about the issue of, and it's on your handout there, affection versus love. Okay? And we're going to keep with the theme today, or affection versus attention. I'm sorry. Affection versus attention. She is in Charlotte Simmons in the story is in a position where she is alone. She has no friends. Everyone's older than her. There's peer pressure going on. And she suddenly feels the value of getting attention. That substitutes for her in that moment the love, the affection of everyone around her. And she uses that attention then to get back at people because they're all looking at her. Right? You guys know what I'm talking about? Does that make sense? She settles for attention, and it feels good in the moment. All right? It feels good in the moment, and that's a very poignant example of that, especially for young women who can use the way that they dress oftentimes to get attention for themselves. Men have different ways of getting attention, but that is a very good illustration, I think, of an example where we can use getting attention to substitute for the fact that we're getting affection. I think that drives also a lot of the stuff that we see today on the internet with Facebook and everything else. Facebook, all those things are fine. They're great. I use them. All right. But sometimes I think what motivates people is not so much the urge to connect and be with other people, but to get attention. Look how funny I am. Look what I post. Look at the video that I found. It's really cool. You know, wanting to get attention about the friend count. You know, how many I got 2,000 friends, right? All of those things can, in the moment, substitute for affection, but it never lasts. Very quick burning thing. All right. Any thoughts on any of that from your own life or anything as you were reading the story? Any thoughts, concerns, comments? Have you ever felt the lure of attention in your own life, and as a way to substitute for the fact that you were really what you really wanted was affection or love? Awesome. Okay. All right. Childhood wounds. We're going to get back to love here in a minute, but I want to review. We're going to go through this and review. We're looking at the childhood wound exercise, okay, because that's another thing that we've been looking at. We're setting the stage for an in-depth examination of marriage and what it means to be married and to be loved. And also then we're going to dive into some of the false things about marriage, contraception, in vitro fertilization, homosexuality, those kinds of things. But we have to set the stage for that. One of the things that we want to do today is do what's called a childhood wounds exercise. What is what are childhood wounds?
Things that go with you, like you think about your entire life.
Think, yeah.
Something traumatizing to you.
Right. Yeah, it was trauma for you. The person may not have meant to do anything harmful to you, or they may have meant to do something harmful to you. Nonetheless, it's things that we carry with us from our childhood into our adulthood. Okay, and so we need to be aware of how those affect us. If you would, if you could turn your page over to the back, okay, to the blank side of the paper. Now, I think you're really going to be surprised by this. It's a pretty interesting exercise. Okay. Okay, so what I want you to do for a second, actually, okay, is, now this is going to sound really hippie-ish, okay, and like this is what I did every day in religion class when I was growing up, right? Okay, I want you to close your eyes, all right? But trust me, it's all right. I'm not going to surprise you, do anything crazy, okay? Going to set the stage for you visually. I want you to see yourself in this situation. It's going to help you answer some questions, okay, about some of this stuff, all right? So I want you to close your eyes and imagine your childhood home, the earliest one that you can recall, okay, the very first one that you can recall. Imagine yourself as a young boy or a young girl, and I want you to try to see the rooms from that you grew up in from the perspective of a small child. Wander around the house and find the people who influenced you most deeply as a child. Maybe it was a grandparent, maybe it was your parent, or two parents. As you encounter these people, you will be able to see them with new clarity. Stop and visit with each one. Note their positive and negative traits. Tell them what you enjoyed about being with them. Tell them what you didn't like about being with them. Finally, tell them what you wanted from them but never got. Don't hesitate to share your angry, hurt, or sad feelings. In this vision, your caretakers will be grateful for your insights. Okay? So now you can go ahead and open your eyes, and I want you to answer a couple of questions. Okay? What I want you to do is to, on your paper, if you could draw a large circle. Okay? So you're going to draw a large circle, I don't know, 2 inches. Okay? 2 inches in diameter, maybe. Okay? Divide the circle in half with a horizontal line. Okay? Put the capital letter B on the top half of the line and put a capital letter A on the bottom half of the line. All right. On the top half, next to the B, I want you to list all the positive character traits of your mother, father, or any other person who influenced you strongly when you were young. Okay? Lump all the positive traits of all these people together. So, anything positive that you picked up from someone who helped raise you or who was influential in your childhood, I want you to list them in the top half of the circle. Okay? So just kind of some catchphrases or words that you feel like summarize the positive character traits that you picked up from people who helped raise you. Kind, warm, intelligent, religious, patient, creative, enthusiastic, reliable. Okay, whatever it may be. Is somebody whistling? Layla? Are you okay? You don't look so okay. Are you able to follow along? Okay. We're doing an exercise on the back. Right there. If you can draw that illustration up on there on your paper. Okay, on the bottom half, next to the A, list the negative traits of these key people. Negative traits. All of them together. Angry, violent, belittling, childish, rude, whatever. Okay? So, you know, ideally you find 4 or 5, probably, characteristics that go on top, 4 or 5 that you feel like were probably negative that would go on the bottom. All right. If you would go ahead and then circle the positive and negative traits that affect you the most. Then circle all of them. Yeah. If it's all of them, circle all of them. But if you can hone in on a couple that you feel like most affect you still today, if you can circle those.
These are supposed to be about the person that we like.
Yes. Yep. But now you're going back and looking at those and kind of asking yourself which ones affected you the most growing up.
From them.
Yeah. Okay. Below the circle, I don't want to rush you. If I am rushing you, then just tell me to slow down. Okay. Below the circle, if you can write a C. Okay. And I want you to write next to that.